my duties entails to liaise with the communities out there, by so doing also making them aware of the criminal activities happening in their area. I met Skumbuzo in one of the invites that we received 2016. I invited them to my office. We planned and discussed on how are we going to help each other, because their motive and their vision was the same as mine.
As part of her community outreach program, she organizes regular anti-drug talks at local schools. I'm here at the Tembisa West Secondary School to witness something that Skumbuzo has been doing for the past 6 years. Since he quit using and dealing drugs, he's been telling his story to school kids, hoping to inspire them to not repeat the mistakes that he made.
This uniform, I call it a uniform of white. But you know why? Because the uniform is not full in there, not full in there. If you're wearing this uniform with pride and you do, and you carry yourself, and then who are you uniform, guys? But a uniform of shame. I call it the uniform of shame. Man, come on, I eat my chance, my chance.
With Do School Talks, I'm basically a qualified drug education specialist, and also being someone who actually didn't just do the theory and been there hands-on. So I'd go to schools, mostly I'd touch on drugs.
He is not ashamed of speaking out about his past. If this person can change from what he says he experienced as a child, and to be the person that is standing here in front of me now and speaking about it, then what makes me be ashamed?
Substance abuse is becoming a real factor here around our community. Almost everywhere you look, you see people like smoking, nyaupe, and all types of drugs. So when he said that you must replace your uniform of shame with a uniform of excellence, I really felt that, because it proves that education comes first.
Over the years, Sergeant Mogale and Skumbuzo have developed a close bond.
I look at her as my mom's, because she's played a huge role in my life and a huge mother figure role.
Skumbuzo, my boy. I always call him that. Skumbuzo is relating to me as his mother because of the relationship that we share. You must not only see me as a police officer who's going to assist you, you must also relate to me as your parent. Simply because if you do that, it will be easy for you. When you find challenges, you know that my door is open.
Skumbuzo has certainly turned his life around since the mugging, but recovery from substance abuse is never a straight line. There have been ups and downs, from the high of becoming a father to his baby daughter, to the low of relapsing in 2019.
For me, it was a bad year. Shuti, my crazy was sick. I had to stop my booking. I had to stop Ugo Hasil. I had to make sure that Exen, Peggy, Udlile, Nana, and medication. And that happened from February right up until October. It was the time where it was my lowest, being depressed.
One of his friends came to my office to say, I'm concerned, Skumbuzo is back on drugs. Then I said, you know what? Skumbuzo knows my doors are open. When he needs help, he will come to my office. Rather, let him be prepared and to take the responsibility of his actions and come and face me. So he came to my office, we sat down, then he expressed and spoke out about his relapse.
When she asked me when I was ready to do a school talk, I was like, I'll tell her when I was. I spoke to the kids and I actually even confessed that I had relapsed and stuff. That was when I actually opened up about what I was going through the past year. I thought about my daughter the most. I felt like I don't want to turn into my dad. I don't want to be the guy who was not there for his child. Not being able to be part of my daughter's life because I was probably going to be a junkie or go back to dealing. I think me having a daughter changed my perspective.
Italian recovery to take one day at a time, and that's exactly how Skumbuzo Mokoena tries to live. It's Friday afternoon and he wants me to meet some of the kids in the township who he's taught to dance.
I'm gonna show you the Pantula dancers from my arts foundation. We've been together for like, I think three years if not four. They've been part of us and they keep growing. Some leave us and focus on other things, and then the crew just keeps growing, because every time we hold rehearsals, we're always teaching new kids how to dance. We usually have rehearsals here at my spot, but right now I just want us to give you something a little raw on the streets so you can see what they do.
The person that Skumbuzo is now He has become an influencer. He's become a mentor. You know, he has become, you know, a public figure, especially in the location. He has done good for himself. You know, like just to now bring back his image or his reputation.
He's committed, working at the Pick and Pay. And he's also committed to coming back to the office when he's off to see to it that the office is still in good running and what project are we planning and how we can assist, and also looking after his granny. So where he is now, I think it's where he should be.
Having overcome so much in his life, the man I've met still seems to be driven by his never-ending quest for redemption.
Baba Tosezulwe. Amen.